The horseshoe map that we've been analyzing is really great. It's awesome, but it's not all there is. Let's take some time to think about how to generalize things. Now, what is it that we want to generalize? What features of the horseshoe really matter to us? Well, there's the idea that it's invertible. That was very nice. And it's chaotic, but chaotic in a way that we can control in the sense that there are symbolic dynamics. So if I look at the action of the horseshoe map F on its invariant set lambda, then I can get a correspondence or a topological conjugacy between that and the shift map on the space of bi-infinite symbol sequences in zeros and ones. Now, such a system, such a symbolic dynamics is called a full shift on two symbols. That terminology is new to us. It's very specific to what is happening in the horseshoe. And the reason for that specialized terminology is that there are many other similar systems for doing symbolic dynamics in different maps. Here's an example of something that is also going to be called a full shift, but something a little different. I'm going to take a square, just like with the horseshoe map, but instead of identifying two horizontal strips, I'm going to identify three horizontal strips. And instead of having the action of the map bend it around into a horseshoe, what I'm going to do is that same squeezing and stretching and bending, but now I'm going to keep going when I bend it. And I'm going to bend it around into this curly shape, like I'm folding dough for a croissant or something like that. But the idea is that I've got three horizontal strips. Let me call them H0, H1, H2, that get stretched out into vertical strips. Now, this is just like the horseshoe, but it's kind of extra. And what I mean by extra is that it's got some extra symbolic dynamics. For this system, if we intersect those forward and inverse images of the square, going more and more and more, getting thinner and thinner and thinner, then what we get, again, is an invariant set, lambda, with this map acting on it. That set is going to be a Cantor set. It's just going to look like dust. But what we can do is assign itineraries to points based on which strip they're in as a function of time. That itinerary is going to again be a bi-infinite string, but in three symbols, 0, 1, and 2, corresponding to those three horizontal strips. The shift map is going to act on this space of bi-infinite strings, and we're going to get a topological conjugacy to the action of the map on the invariant set. This is called a full shift on three symbols, as opposed to the full shift on two symbols for the horseshoe map. Now then, such a system is definitely chaotic. Same proof as before. You've got a dense periodic orbit set and sensitive dependence if you write down a random sequence of zeros, ones, and twos, etc., etc., etc. This system is also structurally stable. Why? If I perturb this map a little bit, what it does is it jiggles the horizontal and the vertical strips just a bit. Because we're taking intersections of these things, everything is going to work out same as before. But this system is also a little bit richer than the horseshoe that we have looked at. How many equilibria does this system have? You can figure that out. How many period 5 orbits does this have? You can figure that out as well. There's a little bit more going on in this map. Now, we're at the beginning of a very cool story. There is so much more to symbolic dynamics beyond the horseshoe. Based on what we've done so far, I think you can imagine what is meant by a full shift on n symbols. And I bet that you could write down a map that executes that. But what we're really going to be interested in is something called subshifts. That's what's going to come up next.